you talk about youth that are started from nothing and now they have built a strong business, I don't know any.
I don't know anyone actually. Actually, I personally, I can agree with you because if you see our young entrepreneurs, even just they perform, used to perform well,
yeah.
But today, it's like they want to close in the next 3 years.
No, it needs to be changed. The government needs to be coming out. They need to give more access to funding, but less control. There's too much control, and there's too much of bureaucracy for those young men and women to. You know, if you want to do a business today, a data business, you need license from London, right? I mean, rural. You need a license from BCR. If you want to do mobile money, you need so many licenses. And then, running revenue, a lot of those young men and women, they don't know about taxes. So they start business. Eh? They don't get an accountant, because it's money they don't have. They don't do. And they tell you here, they tell you, the first year you don't have to pay taxes. That's true. You don't have to pay taxes. But what they don't tell you is you don't have to pay corporate tax. But you still have to pay employee tax. You still have to pay VAT. You still have to pay Murenge tax. They don't tell you that. So I've seen so many of them. The young men, they come, they register, they do everything, they don't pay nothing. And then a year comes, we don't teach them how to keep receipts, how to make sure they file everything. After a year, rather than revenue, do an audit. They have no paper. Of course, you get fined. You get fined a few millions. They quit. So there also has to be a much better training for those entrepreneurs. The training we are, and me, that's what I'm telling you. That's what I do now. You guys should also partner with local entrepreneurs to come and talk to you. Because how are you going to train? You, I know you've been in business, but I've seen a lot of training for entrepreneurship that never been in business themselves. It doesn't make any sense. How are you going to have somebody who's never been in business to train about entrepreneurship?
That's a theory. That's the problem you actually have. It's like preaching things that never work.
He doesn't even know. That's not even the guy's fault. He doesn't know. He probably gave him a training to train the students. But him himself never been in business, so he's just gonna repeat whatever he read. But there's no context. He can't give you some inside information that only another entrepreneur would know. They run out of money. Because on average it takes 3 to 5 years for a company to be cash flow positive. It's a fact.
Yes.
Very few companies becomes cash flow positive the first year. First year, so you have to have a budget. And most people run out of budget. Because there's no access to funding, they close down. For our business is even harder because we're in the technology, hardware technology development. For hardware it takes 10 to 20 years.
10 to 20.
To be cash flow positive. Can you imagine? I've been here, no, but it's a, because, you know the kiosk cost us a little bit over $1 million just to develop. Just on developing. I'm not even talking about implementing, buying. Just to develop that technology, it cost us so far $1 million. Imagine what you have to do to run. If I was stuck in living and stuck in Rwanda only, I would have closed down a long time. 100% of our fund come from Europe, America, and cable. Zero from Rwanda. Zero fund from Rwanda. I'll be out of business a long time. So we need to solve this thing. There's a lot of initiative within the government that can lead to that type of thing. But the number one thing it needs to be done is a more partnership between public and private. Local private.
Local partnership.
Because us Rwandese, we think, oh, locals are small guys.